Synovial joints are the third and final type of functional classification. The rest of this chapter has to do with synovial joints. These are the joints that you think of when you think of joints in your body, like shoulder, elbow, finger joints, wrist, knees, etc. Synovial joints have a fluid-filled cavity to lubricate motion, and all synovial joints are diarthrotic. Recall that diarthrotic is a functional classification, meaning free movement. So synovial joints are most of the joints in your body besides the one we covered in previous slides here. These are the distinguishing features present in all synovial joints. They all have an articular capsule to isolate the inside of the joint from the outside of the joint. There's articular cartilage, which is hyaline cartilage. We know hyaline cartilage exists at the end of long bones, but we call that articular cartilage. All synovial joints have a synovial membrane, and this membrane contains cells that secrete synovial fluid into the space, synovial fluid being the fourth distinguishing feature. And all synovial joints are connected by ligaments. Ligaments could be outside the capsule, which are extrinsic. They can be inside the capsule, which is not seen here, or can be part of the capsule itself. Regardless of the type, ligaments connecting the two bones together is a distinguishing feature of synovial joints. These are three features that some synovial joints contain, but many do not. Articular discs are little pockets of fibrocartilage that we see in the knee. We also call those menisci. A bursa is a pocket of synovial fluid to help reduce friction in joints, and tendon sheaths wrap around tendons to help reduce friction. We'll look at a picture of these three. Here's a pocket of fibrocartilage in the knee. Each one is a meniscus. There's our bursa, which roll with the movement to help reduce friction, and very similar to a bursa, but long and wrapped around tendons, those are tendon sheaths. Again, they're designed to reduce friction between the bones. Synovial joints are diarthroses, meaning they're freely movable. So what's stabilizing the joint? Well, the shape of the joint surface plays a role, but it's minor. Think of a ball and socket joint. If there was nothing holding the ball in the socket, it would just fall out. Ligaments connect bone to bone, and that helps prevent too much movement, but still plays a limited role in stabilizing the joint. But if you look at all the muscles here that become tendons that cross the joint, and the tone of the muscles, meaning partially contracted muscles pulling one bone towards the other, that is the most important factor stabilizing joints.